Hi, and welcome to part two of my SwiftUI for iOS 15 course. This is Meng, I'm from Design Plus Code. In part one, we learned a lot about the foundation, the basic layout techniques. We learned how to create a custom tab bar with animation so that we can switch back and forth between the screens. Then we learned a lot about the new SF Symbol 3, how to customize the icons, also how to import SVGs from Figma, turn it into Swift, then use the new canvas so that we can use the timeline animation and animate this beautiful blob in the background. We learn a lot about the new list options in SwiftUI 3 and also how to set up the project structure so that we have a solid foundation to build on. In this second part, we're going to take it to the next level. First of all, we're going to learn how to create a custom navbar so that when we scroll, we can animate the title and create this beautiful gradual blur. And then we'll learn how to use the tab view in order to set the pagination horizontally. And then we can animate using parallax as well as some really nice effects. Then we'll learn how to set up a custom transition so that we can go to the detail screen and work with the parallax as well as how to use gesture to come back to the previous screen. As always, there are a lot of steps in between that I don't even mention, and I put a lot of efforts to make sure that each of these steps are progressive, easy to understand, and use the best practices while pushing the envelope and experiment with new techniques that will make your app really stand out. So we have a lot to cover, and we're going to start with a custom navbar today. Back in Xcode, let's focus on the home view. And here we have a simple screen with the featured item card. Even though this is a very custom layout, most screens are going to be scrollable because you will have more content vertically. So if I play this, you can see that this is not scrollable at all. To fix that, we can command click on the VStack, click on embed, and put that into a scroll view. As a result, any layout inside will scroll. Starting with the VStack here, you can see that the background blob is a little bit clipped, and that's because we used offset using a negative Y value. What I intend to do in the future is to reuse this element multiple times, and to simplify my home view layout, I'm going to create a component out of this. First of all, we're going to go to the components folder, right-click on it, new file. We're going to name this one using the SwiftUI view. It's going to be named featured item, enter. So now I can just go back to the home view and copy everything inside my scroll view, including the modifiers as well as the VStack, cut all of that, and then bring that to the featured item. Replace the text. So if you resume, you're going to be able to see exactly the same layout as before. Then we're going to go back to home view and then reference featured item parentheses. Let's resume this. To create a custom navbar, depending on the complexity of your layout, it should be fairly simple. All you need to use essentially is an overlay. And then we can put a text element, then put the title. So it's going to be featured. Now, the reason why we're using an overlay is because when you scroll, you want your navbar to be sticky at the very top. Let's just customize the style for that title. First of all, we're going to use the font large title, and we're going to set .weight bold. Then we'll want to make it align to the left side. So we're going to need to use .frame, max width, infinity, then set the alignment to leading. Next, we'll want to have some padding from the left to be the same as the padding of the cards as well as the rest of the content. I'm going to set padding.leading 20. Let's try to align this to the top, but also add a background underneath. To do that, I'm going to use a ZStack. So embed in ZStack. And then right before the text, I'm going to use color.clear. Now the color is the same as the shape, which is going to take the maximum size. In fact, if I set this to blue, you're going to see exactly how much space it's taking. Let's use clear because we're going to add a background using ultra thin material. Now this whole Z stack is going to be our nav bar, and we're going to set a frame so that we can have a limited height to 70. Let me just fix the indentation for the padding as well as for the frame. And then we're going to align the nav bar to the very top of the screen by using frame max height to infinity, alignment, top. Let me fix the indentation here. And now you can see that I have a beautiful, simple nav bar for the moment that allows me to set it above the content. Obviously, this is just the start because a nav bar, you can customize the content, you can have buttons, and then we're going to be able to transition during scroll. But first of all, I want to show you a really cool effect, which is to blur the material. So we're going to add a modifier called blur using radius to 10. And just like that, we were able to create a beautiful gradual blur that you see a lot in the App Store app, but also when you scroll during search. So we have this beautiful gradual blur here. Now, technically, it's not exactly the same effect, but it's pretty close. And unfortunately, Apple has yet to share their exact technique here. All right, now that we have our simple navigation bar, we can create a new file in navigation folder and new file. We're going to name it navigation bar. Enter. Here, I'm going to move from the home view everything, including the Z stack, reference navigation bar parentheses, and then go back to navigation bar, replace the text with the Z stack. As a result, it should look like this in my navigation bar file. And we're going to make the title customizable because we want to be able to reuse this navigation bar in multiple screens. So let's set a variable title is equal to empty by default. Now this implies that it's a string, so I don't need to set the type. And then using the variable, we're going to replace the hard-coded title with title. So when you work with empty defaults for your components, what you can do is to set the preview to not be empty. Inside the parentheses, I'm going to set a title, and let's say by default, we're going to use featured. And what is interesting about the preview is that you can customize it any way you wish, and it's only going to affect your preview and not the actual app. This is where you can test in dark mode, accessibility features, and with different data. Now let me go back to home view. Since the navigation bar has a default title, which is empty, it's not going to require it, but I can decide to customize by setting the required value. So as you can see on the basic level, to create a custom navbar, it's very simple. But what's going to be hard is when we're going to add the beautiful transition, detecting the scrolling, adding the buttons, and animating the title. And another thing that I wanted to show you was how to use the safe area inset so that we can fix this spacing problem for the content. And that's also going to be useful for the tab bar. I'll show you that technique in the next session. I'll see you then.